Jessie V, and in today's video, I'm gonna be walking you through how to contact fairies, which I know probably sounds a little crazy. Now, there are some dangers to doing this, and there are some good things about doing it if it works. There are actually many people around the world that still believe fairies to be a very real thing, and I could not believe that there's actually a step-by-step process online of how to get them, like how to actually see them and bring them to your house. It's insane. Before I get started though, we have a bunch of new fairy themed items and I thought it would really go well with this video. The first thing is that we put up magical fairy garden sets on the website. We've never done this before. These are probably my most favorite things we've ever had. So you get three things with your set and they're actually very large. So first you get this awesome fairy door. It's covered in vines. It has a little window. It has like stone. It has a little bunny rabbit right there. So you get a whole fairy door. And then you also get two fairies to go along with it. One is standing and one is sitting on a little mushroom. So you get all three of these things in your set and you can put it anywhere outside, in your garden, by a tree. But people actually believe that if you start a fairy garden outside your house, it will actually attract fairies. So if you have fairy doors, little fairy houses, if you have little fairy figurines, it attracts them. It's crazy. Obviously, I can't guarantee that you'll get fairies from these, but I think they're really cute, awesome sets. There are only 24 sets available, so if you would like one, I've linked it down below. And also, I have made pixie dust bracelets. There's only one available of each different color. I think there's like 10 to 12 colors. There are 6 little orbs on everyone's charm bracelet, and inside there's little pixie dust. So if you guys would like one of my pixie dust bracelets, I've linked it down below. I love them so much. All right, guys, so now that we're past all the actual fairy stuff that you can go and get if you would like to, let's get into how to contact fairies. There's actually a large amount of people who not only believe fairies are real, but genuinely want to know how to contact them. Belief in the existence of fairies appears to go back as far as the 13th century. And I've actually made a ton of videos about fairy history, so we're not gonna be going into that today, only how to contact them. So if you wanna see a fairy in real life, keep watching. All right, to start off, you have to declare that you're only interested in seeking out friendly fairies. Because while it might seem that all fairies are just precious and sweet and wonderful, that's not always the case. Just like humans, there are fairies with a lot of different personalities, and there are such things as evil and dark fairies. So unless you're looking to speak to the dark and scary and difficult fairies, you need to go out and say, those with bad intentions are not welcome here. You need to make it loud and clear so those ones go away and you're only attracting the good ones. Next, you have to travel to their home environment. While summoning a fairy into your home is certainly possible, there's a higher chance you'll see and hear fairies when you're outdoors. Those who have contacted fairies before say they live in nature. So whether you're out in the middle of the forest or simply out in your backyard garden, you need to surround yourself with trees and plants and flowers. You need to be immersed in nature. While you're outside, find a nice tree to sit underneath. And as you sit with your eyes closed, you might try bringing out a flute and playing it for just a minute. You actually have a better chance of going out in a forest with an instrument because fairies love music, they love nature, and that combination is just really good. The only kind of flute I know how to play is a recorder from school, and those things don't sound very good. The next thing you have to make sure is that you're not wearing any of your clothing inside out. Turning your clothing inside out might actually drive away any fairies you might encounter, so make sure to double check your shirt, your pants, your jacket. Apparently, if you're wearing any of your clothing the wrong way, it will drive them away. Isn't that so strange? The next thing you have to do is dance and sing and rid your house of any negativity. If you want fairies to come to your house or into your house, it's important that they're entering a positive environment. And one way to create that positive environment is to sing songs and to dance. Now, there are quite a few different chants you can say to bring the fairies to your home. And this is actually a real one, okay? It says, fairies, the child in me, let's happiness be, push away dark clouds, let joy flow free. Imagine like all the fairies just like attack me right now. So if you say that in a singing voice while you're like dancing around, they will come to you. It also says that if your house smells of like cigarette smoke, or you have a bad relationship, or there's just toxic negativity in your life and in your house, fairies don't want to be around that. Next is to leave them food offerings. Apparently apparently fairies are very food motivated, just like a lot of creatures are. So leaving out some of their favorite foods as offerings appears to go a long way in the attempt to speak to these creatures. Apparently, those who have met fairies say they like to have raw chocolates, candies, cakes, ginger, and barley. Apparently, they're attracted to all of those things. Others say that simply putting some honey in an accessible place is enough to make fairies willing to make contact. Some people put out a little bowl of honey on their front porch on a full moon, and apparently that brings them in. Isn't that strange? Next, it says to clean your home so it's not full of clutter. And that kind of goes along with the whole negativity thing. Your house just needs to be a positive, clean place. It's not enough to simply tidy up. Fairies are apparently attracted to clean spaces, so you may have to go as far as to scrub the dirt off the floors and really make sure that everything is sparkling. It even suggests to bring out some essential oils. Fairies love a good, nice smelling place. A very strange one is that it says to remove any iron objects from outside of your house or inside of your house. If you're a fan of folklore, you might already know that iron repels fairies. In most stories involving fairies, anytime a cold iron skillet or some cold iron object is brought out, it gets rid of fairies and fairy energy. So let's say you have some dark fairies come into your house. All you need is some iron and they will run away so fast. But yeah, if you want them in your life, iron could actually harm them. Next, you're gonna wanna sit around flowers and plants, which is kind of what we spoke about before. A simple way to create an environment that makes fairies feel welcome and at home is by surrounding yourself with plants and flowers. Nature is attractive to fairies, so if you're setting up a fairy house outdoors, put flowers and plants all around it. Now, it says that fairies don't like any chemicals or pesticides, so make sure your garden is free of that. And lastly, it says to carry a rose crystal or something shiny to attract them. Fairies are attracted to shiny, sparkly things. And that is why in most depictions of fairies, especially in folklore and stories, they're always surrounded by pixie dust, which is why I made those pixie dust bracelets. So when people are trying to contact fairies in real life, a lot of the time they have sparkly things, shiny things, they carry around crystals. Apparently there's actually a crystal called fairy wand quartz, which I've never heard of before, but if you have that and you put it by your windows or by your front door in your garden, they will arrive. Anyways though guys, those are all the things I found about how to contact and summon the fairies. I feel like it would be so cool if it actually worked, because if I could meet a fairy in real life, my life would be complete. Anyways though guys, if you have anything else to add, definitely comment it down below. And if you've ever seen a fairy, also comment that, because that's crazy. Don't forget, if you would like a fairy garden at your house, or if you would like a pixie dust charm bracelet, I have linked everything down below. But I hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! Thank you.